Let's look at some other sleep disorders, doctor. Sleep apnea, periodic limb movements. Well, what is that?
Periodic limb movements and restless leg syndrome go together. Restless leg syndrome is an abnormal or uncomfortable feeling in the legs that comes on at night. That gets better with, especially just before we're ready to go to sleep. It gets better when we move around, so it keeps people from going to sleep. When we do a sleep study in someone with restless legs, we'll frequently see periodic leg movements. So it's a finding. Periodic limb movements is a finding on the sleep study, but the important disorder is restless leg syndrome. It can be treated, so if it's interfering with sleep, we want to identify it. Narcolepsy is a disorder of hypersomnolence or excessive sleepiness. It's a neurologic problem that has its onset in the teens and 20s and can lead to significant impairment due to sleepiness. It's not nearly as common as sleep apnea or insomnia or some of the other medical problems, but a lot has been learned about sleep from studying patients with narcolepsy. And then circadian rhythm sleep disorders refers to abnormalities of our body rhythm that affect how we function during the day.
All right, and what if someone really doesn't know they have sleep problems? Let's say they don't have someone next to them. How do they know they're having sleep issues?
Well, a lot of times people will have symptoms during the night. They wake up during the night, or they can't get to sleep during the night. And then there is the whole issue of how they feel during the day.
Mm-hmm.
If someone wakes up feeling tired and is sleepy during the day, then we suspect that there might be something going on.
And what diseases are associated with sleep disorders?
Well, sleep disorders can have a significant impact on our overall health and increase our risk for cardiovascular problems, in particular high blood pressure, heart disease such as heart attacks, cardiac arrhythmias, diabetes, risk of stroke. All these are associated with sleep abnormalities. And there's been a lot of research in recent years that shows insufficient sleep, even if the sleep is not affected by one of these disorders, but just an insufficient amount of sleep can be associated with being obese, having increased appetite,
mm-hmm.
and overall poor health.